stand.
First book of Kings. Elijah the Tishbite from Tishbe in Gilead said to Ahab, "As the Lord, the God of Israel, lives, whom I serve, during these years there shall be no dew or rain except at my word." The Lord then said to Elijah, "Leave here, go east and hide in the Wadi Cherith, east of the Jordan. You shall drink of the stream, and I have commanded ravens to feed you." So he left, and did as the Lord had commanded. He went and remained by the Wadi Cherith, east of the Jordan. Ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning, and bread and meat in the evening, and he drank from the stream. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our help is from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
Our help is from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
I lift up my eyes toward the mountains. Whence shall come help to me? My help is from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. May he not suffer your foot to slip. May he slumber not who guards you. Indeed, he neither slumbers nor sleeps, the guardian of Israel.
Our help is from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
The Lord is your guardian, the Lord is your shade. He is beside you at your right hand. The sun shall not harm you by day, nor the moon by night.
Our help is from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
The Lord will guard you from all evil. He will guard your life. The Lord will guard your coming and your going, both now and forever.
Our help is from the Lord, who made heaven and earth.
Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land.
Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. Thus they persecuted the prophets who were before you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Collect, opening prayer of Mass, spoke about, O God, from whom all good things come. Today we hear about the ravens feeding Elijah bread and meat in the morning and the evening. That's kind of a very supernatural way to receive good gifts in our daily food. But I don't think it's much more miraculous than somebody driving by the rectory at 5 p.m. dropping off food for us. We don't know who these people are. We don't know who's on the schedule. And yet, every day, or the days and schedule, according to God's will, food just shows up. Even in, you know, seminary, you just show up to the cafeteria and there's food there every day. These delicious meals, three times a day, actually. And even growing up in our own homes, you know, we had good parents, good families, and I don't know how my mom did it, but every day, food just showed up. And whether it's a raven or a mom with a cafeteria staff, unknown parishioners, all good things come from God. They come from His providence, from His love for us, His desire for us to be happy and healthy people. Elijah didn't get to pick the meat that he got each day. Get a pick, you know, I like sourdough bread a little bit more. He said a raven with sourdough bread. And God wanted Elijah to trust that everything that he receives, even things that maybe he didn't understand, he's called to receive them as a gift from God. And that's true of the food we eat, the water we drink, the books we read, the people we encounter. So many good things God is trying to bring into our lives. And for some of these good things, it takes a degree of trust to accept it as something good and not just something that maybe I'm not wanting right now, or I have better plans or a better idea. God's providence has been watching over us all our lives. He watches over us today. Prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for all of our bishops, that they may be strengthened in the upbuilding of the kingdom of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all of our government leaders and civil servants, that they may always seek to promote the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who are sick and suffering, that they may be touched by the healing hand of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for all those who have died and will die this day, that they may rest in the peace of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for hearing our prayers and petitions, and we ask that you may grant them all in accord with your most holy will, through Christ our Lord. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take
away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only to say the word, and my soul. prince of the heavenly hosts, but of our God, Christ and of Satan, and all the evil spirits, who are out of the world, seeking for his soul.